Hello, I'm Zegam, a graduate student at the University of Science and Technology, South Korea. On behalf of my team, I would like to introduce our work, Cleaning Label Noise with Clusters for Minimally Supervised Anomaly Detection. Anomaly detection is a challenging problem, mostly because of the fact that it is extremely subjective. Something normal for one person might not be normal for another. While this problem might be solved by developing a consensus among humans, there is another major issue which makes it hard for the algorithms to learn to detect anomalies. An event might be anomalous at a certain location, whereas it might be completely normal at other locations. For example, a fire in a stove may be completely normal. However, completely anomalous in the case it is in a bedroom or in a bus. Unlike other datasets in the domain of object detection or classification, it is also not easy to obtain the anomaly examples. Especially, it is not possible to think of all possible kinds of anomalies and obtain training examples for each of those cases. For this reason, weakly supervised algorithms are generally popular for anomaly detection, as they can at least save the costly procedures of obtaining fine-grained labels. Given the intuition that normal data is abundant and relatively easier to obtain, several researchers proposed one-class classification networks. In such frameworks, the classification boundary is learned using only normal data, and during test time, any new data falling outside this boundary is flagged as anomalous. However, a fundamental problem with such architectures is that if the boundary is too tight around the normal data, a new normal data which may be slightly deviant from the learned representations will also be flagged as anomalous. Another protocol for anomaly detection is to utilize both normal and anomalous examples for training. However, to mitigate the necessity of obtaining fine-grained annotations, weakly labeled training is preferred. At this point, one might wonder, why do we need weakly labeled training? So just to put things in perspective, let's take an example image extracted from a video. If we need to obtain frame-level annotation, we can simply label this particular frame as normal or anomalous. In order to locate anomalies, we may also need to obtain pixel-level annotations. It may look simple until here, but we have to repeat this process for hundreds of thousands of frames belonging to the videos of our dataset, which is indeed a costly process. Therefore, a widely popular paradigm of training is to utilize weakly labeled videos. In the domain of action detection or event classification, weak labels for a video defines that a particular action such as playing guitar is present. However, it does not tell about the frame level or pixel level position of the action in that video. Similarly, for anomaly detection, a video is considered normal if all frames are normal, and it is considered anomalous if some of the frames are anomalous. In a weakly supervised method proposed by Dr. Sultani and his team, a positive and a negative bag is created using normal and anomalous labeled videos. There is no anomalous segment in the negative bag, whereas some of the segments may be anomalous in the positive bag. A multi-instance learning ranking loss is then computed given an assumption that each segment in the negative bag should have low score compared to the high scoring segments of the positive bag. A drawback of this approach is that each video, irrespective of its length, should be converted into a same number of segments, which is not always practical in real-world scenarios where events may occur over varying length of time. The authors in this paper approached the weakly supervised learning in terms of label noise removal from the anomalous videos, where the noise referred to as normal frames present within anomalous videos. This is an interesting approach as, by definition, normal videos do not contain anomalies. The approach utilized action classifiers to train graph convolution network, which then helps in cleaning noise from the labels of anomalous videos. Our work is similar in essence to this work, as we also attempt to mitigate label noise present in anomalous videos. Now I will introduce our weakly supervised architecture for anomaly detection. Given we have a video VI with annotation as anomalous, which means some of the frames of this video contain anomalous events. Some frame of the videos are taken to form segments, which is the basic processing block for our system. All segments from one video are viewed as a group of segments. Please notice that our system does not have any information on which of the segments contain anomalous events. The red and blue colors are only for visualization. Each of these segments are passed to a feature extractor one by one, and the features are then input to a fully connected network with two hidden layers of size 500 and 64. Output of this network is a regression score between 0 to 1, 0 being normal and 1 being anomalous. Output of the scores are assigned to each input segment. Now here is the problem. We do not have accurate labels which are necessary to calculate network's loss for backpropagation. Therefore, we introduce a clustering mechanism in parallel to the FC network. The clustering is performed on the output of the first layer of the fully connected network, which is critical because our feature extractor is pre-trained and does not change its output during the training. However, we want our network to gradually improve its output, which is desirable in the training. We obtain two clusters based on the fact that anomaly detection is a binary class problem. The assumption here is that one of these clusters contains normal, while the other contains anomalous segments. However, we do not know which cluster exactly contains the normal segments. At this point, we rely on the experience of the fully connected network to detect normal segments, which it obtains using the segments coming from the normal videos. Therefore, we match the normal segments that were output by our fully connected network to find the cluster with most normal segments. And based on this, we define the annotations of all segments in this cluster as 0, which represents normal. Consequently, annotations of all segments in the other cluster are labeled as 1, which represents anomalous. We use these pseudo labels to compute the mean square error for the output of the network. In addition, we also utilize cluster distance as a metric, which is added as a weighted value to the training loss. In the case of anomalous videos, we encourage the network to produce the latent features which generate more distant clusters. For a normal video as input during the training, segments are created in a similar fashion. Furthermore, the same pipeline of feature extractor and fully connected network is used to obtain the predicted scores. However, here based on the labels of normal videos, we have a certain knowledge that a group of segments does not contain any anomalous segments. Therefore, we simply propagate the video level label as segment level labels. We still use cluster distance as a metric. However, in this case, we utilize it to encourage the network to bring both clusters together. Initially, the learning of the FC network relies on the normal videos, which we know have no anomalies within. The network gradually becomes better in recognizing normal scenes. Meanwhile, the clustering distance loss forces the network to produce similar features in the case of a normal video and more discriminative features in the case of an anomalous video. To find a good balance between declaring all scenes in an anomalous video as normal and to declare all scenes in an anomalous video as anomalous, the network tries to separate out the parts of the video which do not belong to the normal representations. Therefore, even the clustering algorithms does not get trained during the whole process, it still successfully helps the FC network in learning to discriminate anomalous events from the normal ones. As feature extractor, we employ a popular framework for videos called Convolution 3D or C3D. It takes 16 frames as input, therefore we fix the size of our segments as 16. UCF Crime is a dataset which is specifically designed for weekly labeled training for anomaly detection. The dataset contains 13 different classes of anomalies including accident, robbery, arson and so on. Shanghai Tech Campus dataset was initially introduced as one class classification problem. However, to make it suitable for the weekly supervised algorithms, Zhong and his team proposed a new deviant of this dataset. On the UCF Crime dataset, our method outperforms several other state-of-the-art, second only to the graph convolution-based noise cleaner. However, in the case of Shanghai Tech dataset, our method outperforms the graph convolution-based noise cleaner approach by a significant margin of 7.72%. For the ablation study of our proposed architecture, we removed several parts of the network and observed the performance drop on each experiment. When we removed clusters distance loss, a 0.70% drop in the performance on Shanghai Tech dataset and 1.14% drop in the performance on UCF Crime dataset was observed. When we remove pseudo labels, a significant drop in the performance, 2.51% on Shanghai Tech dataset and 1.68% on UCF Crime dataset was observed. Overall, the network shows reasonably discriminative scores between anomalous and normal portions of a video. However, in some cases, the score stays high even after the labels for anomalous events was over. Upon visual inspection, we observed that in most of these cases, even if an abnormal event is over, the scene often does not return to normal right after. For example, in the case of figure A, a car can be seen being chased by police vehicles. After the arrest is made, the cars are still parked on the road, hence the higher score. Thank you very much for listening to our presentation. Please feel free to ask any questions.